Hi, welcome to the Grafana Alloy for Beginners series. My name is Mischa Thompson, and I'm a senior software engineer at Grafana. In the previous episode, we talked about collecting metrics from our application servers. In this episode, we will cover ingesting traces emitted by those applications. These episodes build on one another. Before starting this one, make sure you've watched episodes 1 through 9 and completed Alloy configuration sections 1 through 4 in the repo. To get started, open the Grafana Alloy for Beginners repo and scroll down to section 5. As a quick reminder, each section contains the starter code, tasks to explain what you'll need, and a solution with the finished version. If you haven't already, fire up the learning environment and open config.alloy. I'll go over the OTEL pipeline we'll be building visually and then walk through the solution. Feel free to give it a try on your own first and then compare with the solution once you're finished. All right, let's take a look at the pipeline we'll be building for traces. Our mythical microservices, the server, requester, and recorder, are already configured to emit spans and send them to our Alloy instance. To start ingesting those spans, we'll use the otelcol.receiver.otlp component. As the name suggests, this component receives spans in the OTLP format and forwards them down the pipeline. Next, the spans go to the otelcol.processor.batch component. This component collects spans into batches before sending them on, which is a key practice for reducing network overhead and improving performance. Finally, the batches of spans are sent to the otelcol.exporter.otlp component. This component is responsible for exporting the spans, and in our case, it's configured to send them in OTLP format to our locally running tempo instance for storage. Let's look at the configuration for our otelcol.receiver.otlp component. We've given it the label OTLP receiver, and we've configured it to receive traces via both HTTP and gRPC on ports 4318 and 4317. We've also configured the output block to send spans to our batch processor, which we'll be looking at next. The otelcol.processor.batch component takes incoming spans and batches them together. In its output block, we're telling it to forward batches of spans to the input of our next component, the otelcol.exporter.otlp. We also set some parameters to control its behavior. It will try to send batches of 1,000 spans, but it will not exceed a maximum of 2,000. So a burst of spans will be queued and sent in batches of 2,000 at most. If it doesn't reach the minimum size of 1,000 spans, it will send a batch anyways after a 2-second timeout. Finally, we have the otelcol.exporter.otlp component, which we've named Tempo. This component sends our traces to the client at the specified endpoint, which in our case is the locally running Tempo instance on port 4317. We have also included a TLS block. Since this is a local insecure connection for this demo, we've set insecure and insecure skip verify to true so we can skip TLS verification. Once you've finished, don't forget to reload your configuration and you should get a confirmation saying the config has been reloaded. Once you've finished, scroll down to the verification section and navigate to the dashboards. Go down to section 5 verification and you should now see some data populating. You should see both a service graph, a table of the different traces that we're seeing, and a count of the received spans from Tempo. The service graph does take maybe a couple of minutes to populate, so if you see all of the other data but not this one, just give it a second and you should be able to see data. In this episode, we configured Alloy to ingest spans being emitted by our mythical microservices, batch them, and send them to our local Tempo instance. In the next episode, we will build a pipeline for ingesting application logs with Grafana Alloy.